So hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. It's your GG4K and how are you doing today? The 1.5.1 test server is online and I decided to try out the newly let's say adapted medium tanks, the STB-1 and the Leopard. Today we're gonna review or preview the STB-1 and the Leopard is gonna come in the next video. So this is the 1.5 version, the current version, and this is the test server version over here. Let's see what do we have. The DPM has gone up by 122, that's pretty good. But the next thing is the damage. The damage went down from 390 to 360. Okay, that's something different and interesting. So as the damage goes down, the reload time goes also down from 7.67 seconds to 6.8 seconds, which is pretty awesome. If you add consumables, not like consumables, equipment and good crew, can go up to 5.6 seconds. That's amazing for 360 alpha damage. The aiming time is also very important and went down from 2.2 to 1.9. We all know that the gun handling from the STB-1 was garbage. It was awful. And they changed that. So the dispersion is 0.35, the same. But the dispersion on moving is massively, massively buffed from 0.15 to 0.09. And the tank traverse 2 to 0.09, from which is basically awesome. We all knew that the STB-1 had this big bloom when you were moving or turning the turret, and that was the biggest disadvantage from this tank. They changed the ammo type from APCR to AP rounds, so the shell velocity goes down from 1478 to 1185. The max range is the same, blah blah blah. The shell cost is the same, but it does less damage, so that's a negative point that I have to mention. The mobility, 53 kilometers top speed down to 50 kilometers top speed. But the reverse speed has been buffed from 20 to 25, which is awesome. The power has also been buffed by 200 horsepower, so the power to ton ratio, power to weight ratio is 25.4, and it was 20 on the old version, on the current version. The tank traverse is also has been buffed to 57 from 54. The terrain resistances are all the same, and yeah. And we have an gun depression. The biggest change of this tank is that they added the hydropneumatic suspension. So the same suspension from the Swedish, from the new Swedish medium tanks. And this is not true. Gun depression, that is not true. It goes down to, it was 10, and now it goes down to like 12, 13 or even more. I don't know. There are no stats. I can read them. I don't know. But there is a massive buff to the gun depression too because of the hydropneumatic suspension. So the suspension goes up and down, and it looks pretty cool on this tank too. The hull armor is the same. The turret armor has been buffed a little bit from 195 to 222. So you can brawl tanks. I mean, not brawl tanks. You can use the ridgeline better. The health points have been buffed from 1950 to 2000. The view range. Yeah, the view range has been moved down from 410 to 400 meters. So they're basically turning this tank into a ridgeline warrior, like a frontline ridgeline warrior. They don't want this tank to snipe. They gave this role to the Leopard 1, as we're gonna see in the next video, because I'm gonna preview the Leopard 1 too. They had the massive changes on the Leopard 1 too, so that's gonna be awesome. Yeah, the 3D model is basically the same. The turret is a little bit better over here, but yeah, this gun shield is a little bit better, and that's it. Yeah, this gun shield is not penetrable anymore like it was. That's it. So I think that's enough theory crafting. Let's get into some battles, or one good battle that I had on the test server playing by myself. So enjoy it. And here we go, we have our tank in action. The new STB-1 with the hydropneumatic suspension, a very interesting tank. So these are some drastic changes to the tank, in my opinion, and I'm testing it out, and even on the new map, I mean the new old map, it's just, it has been redesigned, the Kharkov map, it has been made bigger, now it's one times 1 kilometer, so this whole area here was added. I think the old players know what I mean. This area didn't exist. It was only this part here, yeah, that's it. And it looks kind of cool, the map looks cool. I decided to go to this side because I haven't, it didn't change much in the town, in the city part. It just became a little bit smaller. The circle here is smaller, it's not a full circle anymore, it's just only a half circle. And this part has become very big. So I decided to go here and to test out how this tank is performing on some ridge lines. And hell yeah, it looks kind of cool. The hydropneumatic suspension looks awesome on this tank because we are all used to the Swedish tanks, but on a new tank like the STB-1, it looks pretty cool. Yeah, the 360 alpha damage is a big change, though, because you have to fire more, but your fire rate goes up. So actually the DPM went up from, as we talked about in the preview stats. There's gonna be a situation at the end of this battle where you can see how good the mobility has become of this tank. It's more mobile because of the power to town ratio that has become better, and the DPM that also has become better because of the lowering the alpha damage. And here you can see I'm pounding on this E50M, which is in a bad location. He is in the whole rabbit hole down there, and I kill him pretty easily. You saw how fast I did, while like 1260 damage, very easily. And with the good gun depression and the improved turret, there is no chance that he's going to pen me. A small chance is if he penetrates my cupola here, which is not that big. But yeah, it is possible to hit. I hit the STB-1 that shot me before, and you all know the battles on like test servers. It's not like it's going to be, kinda, because everybody is playing so relentless. Everybody's going full in, and it was pretty hard to get a good battle out of it with a solid damage. Because everybody's dying so fast, everybody is playing so fast, it's either 15-1 a win, or 1-15 loss. And this was a kinda a good battle for me, even though you'll see it at the end what is going to happen. Yeah, I'm trying to work this ridge line at the E1 line, so that's the new part of this map, and we're trying to explore this part, and you're seeing that they're overwhelming our city, and the only tank that is left is the Super Conqueror, and he's going to die pretty fast. We are on 1.5k damage. I was playing, let's say so, about 10 to 15 battles, and I was getting average like 2,800, 3,000. It was not under 3,000 damage, which is actually pretty good for this tank. And we'll see. I just decide like, let's go full in. Everybody is, they know that we are at the G1, G2 area because this is the rest of the tanks that is left in our team. So I decided to go to C3 and isolate a heavy tank and kill it. So we have the STB that is hiding down there. I can't find his cupola because he is in a like a hole, like under a ridge. And I'm looking for some more tanks. I tried to hit the Super Conqueror, and I can tell you something, that snapshot capabilities of this tank have been improved massively by dropping down the dispersion from 0.15 on the move to 0.09. It has become a snapshotter, in my opinion. Everybody knows that the gun handling was awful on this tank. Even though you had so good rate of fire, it was almost impossible to use it because as soon as you move your turret, the bloom would go up instantly, like insanely big. And we all know that. And now this is gone. This is gone. And you're gonna see that. You saw that? You haven't been able to do that on the normal server like it is now, to hit a shot while you're driving. It was very, very difficult. So now that's a good point for this tank. And you're having more chances to hit it. So I'm going for the Type 5, and now you can see how I'm gonna isolate him and kill him pretty, and not kill him pretty easily, but yeah, you see there is no chance. I'm moving very fast. You see how good the moving speed, the mobility is. There is a Super Conqueror coming. What is he doing? Oh my god, what is he doing? I'm trying to surround the Type 5. The Type 5, I'm wiggling. The Type 5 is missing. And you see how fast I'm killing this Type 5 in this tank. He was on full health and I was only on 1000. And he hit me once and there's no chance for him to kill me. Yeah, and the Super Conqueror is AFK and the whole team is going for me 8 to 14. These are the kind of the battles that I had. And yeah, I'm trying to get some damage out of this tank, and that's gonna be it actually. You saw like how I'm using the ridge lines with the improved suspension that goes up and down, and killing a full health super heavy tank very easily and very fast. Yeah, I'm missing the shot on the STB-1, and this is probably going to be the last shot that I made. Yep, 343, and he rams me to death. Yeah. So yeah, that was the battle actually. 6.2k damage. Here you can see the enemy that is going up with the suspension. It looks pretty cool, sandwiched between the Type 5 and the STB-1. So yeah, some pretty big changes on this tank. Yeah, it's a wargaming improving spree. The tank that is not played, they're going to buff it, so everybody is going to play it again, and they're doing it all over every tank. Yeah, we're used to it. So the STB is going to be in the meta. We'll see after some few tests that they're going to make on the next test server iterations, but we'll see. So guys, I hope you liked the video. If you have something to say, leave it down in the comments. If you like the video, leave a like, and I hope I'll see you in the next one, guys. Stay awesome. There's going to be a Leopard 1 preview, so stay tuned for that. Bye.